Hello, 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 everybody, to another FM Signals Info Show video edition. My name is still Damir Galch from Good Old Germany, and welcome back to our technical analysis news update. Oh, I've got the wrong template here. Oh, Rick's. Here we are, here we go, yes. Technical analysis news update. Ideas for proactive self-determined forex traders. So analyze this stuff again, guys. It's still yours. Okay, it's meanwhile 23:50 in the evening Central European time. 23:40. Excuse me. 23:48. Oh, what's up? Yes, 23:48. Here, well, I've got this 50 here. At my clock. So, okay, here we are, here we go. Okay, it's 23:48 here in Berlin, or even 17:48 Thursday afternoon in New York. I'm choosing the Euro SE key, so Swedish krona, and I'm pretty surprised about the Euro this week. Start of the week, I tried to short the Euro, but yeah, squeezed out, and now I would slightly prefer the long side, and we will see what will happen in the euro dollar. I uploaded a video a few minutes ago, and let's see what possibilities or trading capabilities we've got in the euro SE key, euro krona. Here we see in the euro krona here today, well, this morning, and great. Sharply falling back here from, let's zoom a little bit. Here we are. This morning we see here, this morning a sharp come down today. Sharp come down round about 866 to 863. And now we are trading here in the middle, slowly boring. And I would still prefer here to go long and take a stop here. Why? Look at this. Here we see the same stuff in black with our, with green and red volumes here, yes. And what's much more interesting is this one. Look at this. We are still in an upside trend. Here, Bollinger Bands on the weekly time frame here. And what's also interesting here, we've got the weekly pivot line and the monthly pivot line. We make a real good recovery, and we see on the oscillation side, we are here still on an intraday sell-off, but we are still in a consistent trend. So if you want a good divergence. So I would still prefer the long side in this cross rate, and try to stay long as a contrarian. Yes, as you say, yes, contrarian. Here we see on the time frame Aaron oscillator, we have switched to the red zone, and also here on the trend indicator, the Ishimoku, yes, Kinko Hiyu, also signals here lower prices for the next for the Asian session. So, but I would still prefer the long side here until the end of the week. Now the clock is ticking. Okay, got a hangover in the clock. The clock is ticking. 23:53 right here right now in Berlin, or 17:53 in New York. However, here we see the trading sessions here in Europe and New York. So, and we see here this we've got here a good yesterday and the day before. Here we traded after Wall Street lower. This week we've got here the sharply come down, yes, and here something like a sideway trend. So, something like a sideway trend here. Yes. So, and this could be perhaps a trading capability to go, to go back in the market long and take a stop. Here we see the high lows of this week here in pink, low, and the high of last week here. Here of last week. So we see we created this week something like a turnaround here. So, and here the moving average here on the moving average, yes. 1 day, yes, 1 day. 1 day, 1 day moving average and weekly moving average, yes. Here we are. And here we are, 8 hours moving average, yes. So the daily moving average here, on the 5 minute chart is still, still in trend, still a great upside trend. So I would prefer here, I would still prefer to go long, even the daily moving average is still intact, the 8 hour moving average here, sometimes I'm using the 8 hour, even for 1 day, Asia, Europe, America, 8 hour, 16, 24 hour, 1 day, so to get a feeling how the sessions was, yes, yeah, sometimes useless, 8 hour too short time frame, but sometimes usefully. And here we see we've got here in America here perhaps something at the top, but I would still prefer the long side in this cross rate. Tomorrow we've got here. Tomorrow here's the day, as the day started. Here tomorrow we will get new call registrations and big data from the economic point of view, Eurozone current account and trade balance. So stay aware, stay cautious, of course, and don't trade without stops. I would create a stop here at the lows. At the low was by 8.6292. So we've got here enough space on the downside. And that's all for today. Yes, that's all for today. I've nothing more on my paper here. Yes, that's all for today. So I would still prefer the long side, even take this sharply turnover as a buying opportunity on a short-term view. See what will happen tomorrow here. Don't ignore the data. Okay, new car registration, not so important, but current account, Eurozone, and trade balance. We will see how the economy grows or not, and how the data came out. And much more important, of course, how the market will react. So all in all, right here, right now, at 23:58, 2 minutes after high noon, or midnight here in Europe on Thursday evening, I would prefer to go long Euro SEK, Euro Krone at 8.6417. Take the stop here and we'll see what will happen on Friday session. So, and perhaps we've got a good setup for next week. However, analyze the stuff again, guys. It's still yours. And my name is still Daimler Galsch from Good Old Germany. And you're always welcome to send me an email, react, analyze the stuff again, agree with me, feel free, disagree. However, make your own conclusions. And that's the reason why I'm saying always analyze the stuff again. It's still yours. I'm over and out for today. Talking to you tomorrow while Wall Street session with our weekly review about our trading capabilities of this week. I'm over and out. It's meanwhile 23:59 on Thursday evening, Central European Time. And my name is still Damian Kalisch from good old Germany. Good morning, good day, good night, wherever and whenever you are. Bye-bye, guys.